All right, and then we have hydrobromic acid and beryllium hydroxide. So we have our strong acid and then beryllium hydroxide is a weak base. And if you forget, just check that list. So then you know that you always get water plus the salt. We're going to put our metal first. So that's beryllium, bromide. Beryllium is a 2 plus. Bromine is a minus 1. So it's going to take two of those. All right, so a strong acid and a weak base. Who wins?
The acid.
Good. So it's going to be an acidic salt. And then we'll break it down into ions. So we always have our H plus. We have bromine, which is a minus 1. Beryllium, which is a 2 plus. And OH, which is a minus 1. How do you tell if it's going to be acidic, neutral, or basic? Basically, your stronger the acid or base determines salt. If it's equal acid base, then it's neutral. And what is pH? It measures the amount of the hydrogen ion. And then we have indicators. Four common types are phenolphthalein, we have bromothymol blue, litmus paper, and universal indicator. pH of 7 is neutral. What's a pH of 2? Acidic. 3, also acidic. Yeah, actually I forgot how bad soda is for you, because it's such an acidic pH. So, I'm changing my life. I'm giving up soda for the sake of my teeth. All right, and the pH of 8 is good. And that pretty much wraps up our acids and bases. So it's a neat little easy unit. If we were in a fancier chemistry class, we would calculate the pH, the hydrogen ion concentration. So your pH is actually it's like the negative log of your hydrogen ions concentrations. But that is for another class. And then ta-da!